guys, Shaunty Phillips here with a brand new DVD Blu-ray Tuesday Shaun video today. Thinking to go out today so things came out, so your things are on sale today. Today though, new release-wise, some of the big things that come out is JoJo Rabbit. And with that one, I don't believe there's any exclusive releases of that one. I'm pretty sure there aren't. Also though, the film Midway releases. And with that one, I believe I saw Target is going to be having an exclusive Steelbook release of that one. I'm pretty sure. And they haven't had an exclusive Steelbook, from what I can remember, in quite a while now. Also though, the film Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood, that released today, as well as 21 Bridges. The Reboot series of Twilight Zone comes out today on DVD and Blu-ray as well. Also though, at the end of this video is going to be a whole bunch of brand new DVD, Blu-ray, and 4K reviews that I received for things I received to review and talk about for you guys. So definitely stay tuned for those. And as always too, let me know in the comments below what you guys thought of the DVDs, Blu-rays, and 4Ks that I reviewed. If you guys have seen them, what you guys thought of them. Also, if you guys plan on picking any of them up. But anyway, guys, let's get going and see what we can find today.
Into Target we go.
And I also wanted to mention, I posted up yesterday, in case you guys didn't see it, a video with me and Danny the Center Stalker going to a book off location where all the DVDs in there were only $1. So it was like a huge store. Normally the book off is like everything is all different prices and everything, but in this one all the books, DVDs, CDs were only $1. So some definitely some cool stuff in there. So that video is up. I'll have a link below if you guys didn't see that one. Also want to mention as well, my friend Dustin Ferguson is working on a new zombie film called Hell of the Screaming Undead, which is going to be in 3D. So it's really cool. It's going to be a 3D zombie movie. And he has a GoFundMe up below for that one. So definitely check that one out. I'll be acting in that one as well. That's going to be shooting at the end of March. So it should be really cool. So a 3D zombie film. So definitely check out the link below for that one as well. But now heading into Target. And let's see if they have that Steelbook in here. Like I said, I saw something about that on Blu-ray.com. So we'll see if that was right. And they do have that.
So in here though, on the front. So all the stuff up here, this stuff has been the past few weeks, but I do see Midway here on Blu-ray, and that one is on $19.99 for the Blu-ray of this one. I talked about this one last Tuesday in my shopping video. Also, Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood, that one released today. It's kind of funny the way it's laid out today. It's like a little different, because like normally they would have like the Blu-ray of like one of these ones up here, not just the 4K, but they have the 4K of Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood. This one I have not seen yet. Let me know if you guys have seen this one, how this one was. You know, it's definitely is one I'm definitely interested in seeing. I feel like I'm gonna wait on this one for the price to go down on this, but it's $29.99 for the 4K of this one. And there is a Midway Steelbook here. Yeah, it's an exclusive Steelbook here for the Blu-ray, and that one is $24.99 for that one. And this is the first time in a while that Target has had, I almost said Best Buy, because Best Buy is always usually having Steelbooks, but I feel like I might be wrong, but I think in the beginning, like a while back, a number of years back, Target was the one that always kind of had the Steelbooks for a while, and then Best Buy wasn't, and now it's been Best Buy for a while. So this is the first Steelbook I've seen though at Target in quite a while, because normally Target has, you know, in the recent years always has like the digibooks. So that's cool. They have a Steelbook for this one here. Like I said, that one is $24.99 for that one. I don't see 21 Bridges here in the front. I'll go check though in the actual section to see if they have that over there. But other than that, here on the side, it seems to be all the same things over here though. You know, no, they do have Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood, the DVD, over here on the side. And that one is $19.99 for that one. So that's kind of funny. Like I said, it's kind of laid out a little differently today, because like normally that would be like right next to this. And it's just, like I said, it's kind of all trying to change around. And then, like, Avengers has been out a long time. That's here. So it's kind of weird how it's all kind of laid out today.
And yeah, though, in the actual section, though, it's kind of funny. It was just like in the front. Everything was kind of all, like, mixed around and everything. It's really weird. Like, the new releases, though, in the section itself were not in the front there. They were, like, on the side of the side. And, like, everything was kind of all mixed up and everything. And they did have, like, 21 Bridges over there on Blu-ray. And they had, like, Midway and A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood, the DVD and Blu-ray of that one. And then I only saw, though, the DVD copy of a JoJo Rabbit. But it was, like, funny, though, how the section was all mixed up like that. Let me know if any of your stores had it all, like your Targets had it all kind of mixed up like that. But it was weird. I've never seen it kind of like all spread all over the place like that. So it definitely was a strange look to the section today.
Into Walmart we go. And uh-oh, I see petitions going on over there. Gotta sneak inside fast before they ask out the petitions.
One thing I always think is funny too is like when you go out in to Walmart, they have like a sign out there that says like, this is a distraction-free zone, you know, like no soliciting or no any of that kind of stuff. So I always think it's funny because like the sign is like right in front usually of where the people are like standing over there, you know. It's always kind of funny how it's like that. You see them like always like with those petitions, but like right where it says distraction free, you know. And if you tell anyone in here, they go, oh, they're out there. They're like, oh, we can't do anything about that. I'm like, oh, all right. Big tower of dog food, but we'll see, you know, hopefully they have all this stuff out in here today though.
But like I was saying though, the big things that came out today was A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood, and the 4K of that one here is $24.96 for that one. And then the Blu-ray DVD combo, that one's $19.96, and then the DVD is $17.96 for that one. Like I said, this is one I'm definitely going to get down the line. I feel like the price would definitely drop on this one. Like that's one of those ones would definitely go down in price. Also though, it's cool, they have right next to it though the documentary on Fred Rogers, Won't You Be My Neighbor? If you guys have not, if you guys have, oh, I know. If they don't have, if you guys have not seen this one though, this one's definitely a must watch. This one's only $9.96 for that one. And then the brand new Twilight Zone series that came out to DVD and Blu-ray. It doesn't look like they have the Blu-ray, but I have a review of this one at the end, and that one's $32.99 for that one. And then Midway, that one is came out today as well. The 4K, that one's $24.96 for that one, $19.96 for the Blu-ray, and then $14.96 for the DVD. And then also 21 Bridges, which I saw this one in theaters. I thought this one was actually pretty good. That one is $22.99 for the Blu-ray of that one, and then $17.96 for the DVD. I'll have to see though. I don't see JoJo Rabbit anywhere here. Let's see if that's on the side. Oh yeah, so they have JoJo Rabbit here on the side, and that one, and this is one I really, really like. This one, I really love this one. That one is $29.96. I'm gonna have a review of this one at the end of this video for the 4K, $22.96 for the DVD, and then $22.96 for the Blu-ray, $19.96 for the DVD. Also though, this one came out today, this one called Snatchers, which I thought was actually a really cool like movie about this one girl who ended up getting pregnant like overnight. She like slept with her boyfriend for the first time and all of a sudden was like pregnant overnight, and then it's like with this alien thing and she has to figure out what she's gonna do. But this one was actually really good. $19.96 for that, $14.96 for the DVD. Other than that though, let's see if there's anything else over here in the actual section, because sometimes there's new things mixed in. Not always, but sometimes there are. But yeah, sorry, there's like a lot of talking over there. Oh yeah, there are a couple other things today. This is one of the other ones I saw that came out. This one here called Disturbing the Peace with Guy Pearce. This is one like I've not heard anything about this one. Let me know guys if this one is worth picking up or not. I'm always a fan of Guy Pearce. Like, and one of my favorite movies, at least two of my favorite of his are Ravenous, and then the other one I always really, really like was Time Machine. Like, that's one of those movies I always hope at some point that ends up getting a Blu-ray release. That's just, like, to me, like, such a great movie. I don't know. I just really love that movie. Other than that, though, see if there's anything else different over here. Trying to see if there's anything else. I think this one, oh yeah, this is one other one that came out today, Clown Fear. And this was actually a pretty cool movie. This one is $14.96. This is about like these people that end up in like in a weird like clown, like motel kind of town village, and they end up getting like kidnapped by these crazy clowns and everything. And then there's another one here for $12.96 called The Dawn. I'm gonna have to look into this one, read this one. I did not know this one was coming out at all. This one looks kind of interesting though. And this one is $12.96 for that one. Other than that though, I'm trying to see if there's anything else different over here. Looks like all the same things here. Yeah, I don't see anything else new over here TV-wise. Like I said, the big TV one was Twilight Zone one. But yeah, other than that though, that seems to be all the main new things here today.
But I have been here a while though, and I've been like filling up these carts of candy. So I've got like full carts of candy. So yeah, at least I got some stuff. You know, I just piled it all in those carts, you know, the big candy carts. But yeah, nothing else over there that I end up getting. If you guys have seen that movie, The Dawn though, let me know how that one was though. And this past weekend, the only new movie that I saw in theaters was Blumhouse's Fantasy Island, which is one I was actually really looking forward to seeing, because I actually really liked the original series, you know, with Ricardo Montalban and of course the character of Tattoo, you know, hey boss, what is this fantasy, boss? The plane, you know, all that. I loved all that. Like, I loved that character, the character of Tattoo, and I like those kind of shows too, where it was like every week is a different story, and they had different guest stars and everything. That's one of those things where I hope so much they start to release them, you know, again, because they only released, I think, like the first three seasons on DVD. I'm hoping at some point, like, there ends up being like a complete series box set on Blu-ray or something like that from Mill Creek, so then you can, you know, can get the whole series at once. That's like one of those things I'd love if came out. But the new one, though, you know, the original series was like a had like comedy aspects to a drama. It was people coming to an island. Every episode, and they all had like a fantasy of like something that they wanted to do, like be king, be a king, be a millionaire, you know, have lots of girlfriends, like all these different kind of things, like be a cowboy, a time traveler, all sorts of things in every episode. And this one was done with like a horror kind of twist to it, where everything is kind of going wrong, and it starred, you know, Michael Pena, Lucy Hale, and Michael Rooker. And it's basically, though, about a group of people going, and they won these tickets to go to Fantasy Island, where their fantasies would come true. And like one, Lucy Hale's character wanted like to get revenge on a bully. These two brothers wanted to be like guys that had a lot of girlfriends and a lot of money. And then one guy wanted to go to war and see what it was like. And basically, though, you know, you think it's going to go well, and everything has like a dark twist to it, what's going on, like a dark aspect to it, where it's like bad things are happening. And I know review wise though, the movie though got like really negative reviews, but to me I kind of see it as one of those like good bad movies. Like, it wasn't really a great movie at all, but it was like kind of a good bad movie, like kind of one that you have a fun time watching. And like there were some really, really cool aspects to the movie. I really love seeing Michael Rooker in the movie. Like, I've always been a fan of Michael Rooker forever. He's good in everything. You know, of course, he was in The Walking Dead. It's one of the biggest things he's known for, but I always think of him from Henry Porter of a Serial Killer and Mallrats, especially like Mallrats. When I think of him playing like Henry is like probably my favorite movie he was in, but Mallrats is like one of my favorite like roles of his, just because he was like playing this like crazy nuts over the top father and stuff. I don't know, I always loved him in Mallrats. But if you guys saw you know, Fantasy Island, let me know what you guys thought of it. Like I said, it's not a great movie, but it was like a fun watch. And you know, let me know in the comments below though, like I said, what you guys thought, or what you guys saw this past weekend, if you guys got to see anything new in the theaters.
Into Best Buy we go. And right here, though, on the front, though, they have A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood for $19.99 on a Blu-ray, $24.99 for the 4K edition of that one. And then JoJo Rabbit here is $22.99 for the Blu-ray, and then $29.99 for the 4K. And like I said, at the end of this video, I'll be doing a review of this one, but really, really love this one. This one is definitely one I would say you guys have definitely got to check out. Love this one so much. Other than that, though, I'll see if there's anything else over here on the side new. So they actually have a steelbook over here for Midway as well. It's a different image on it, and their steelbook here is a 4K steelbook. And it has a kind of their exclusive stickers a little different now. They kind of changed it a little bit. That's kind of interesting. There's two different steelbooks for this one. The Best Buy one for 4K, and then the Target Blu-ray steelbook. So that's cool for that one. And then it's $24.99 for the 4K, and then $19.99 for the Blu-ray of that one. Other than that, though, I don't see anything else new here. I don't see the 21 Bridges. I'll look over in the section, though, and see if they have that over there, though. But over here, though, in the actual section, though, they have the Guy Pearce film, Disturbing the Peace. Like I said, if you guys have seen this one, let me know, though, if this one is worth picking up or not. Like I said, this one here is $14.99 for that one, and they have the Blu-ray edition of The Twilight Zone, and that one is $37.99 for that one. Other than that, though, I'm seeing anything else that I see new in here mixed in or anything like that. They do have over here, though, 21 Bridges, and that one is $22.99 for the Blu-ray of that one. And then Midway over here, Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood, which they had both those ones in the front. And then with Parasite, though, if you guys have not picked up this one yet, I just heard, though, that there's going to be a Criterion Collection release of this one, because the one here only had the Q&A feature-wise, but there's going to be a Criterion release. I don't know when it is, if it's like soon or it's going to be a ways off, but I did hear something about that coming soon. So if you guys haven't picked this one up yet, you may want to wait, because there will be the Criterion one. But this really was a great film, so I'm definitely looking forward to like seeing what kind of features are on the Criterion one. Other than that, though, I don't see anything else new here as far as I can tell. It seems to be all the same stuff in the past couple weeks and stuff, though, but there doesn't seem to be anything else new here, at least, like I said, as far as I can tell. There didn't seem to be any new stands over here. There is one thing that's like a 3 for $35 on 4Ks. So it's like Man of Steel, Superman the Movie, Ready Player One, I Am Legend, Tarzan, Point Break, What was that one there? The Heart in the Heart of the Sea, and then the what was the other one? The Lego Movie. But other than that, though, doesn't look like there's anything else new over here, though.
So anyway, though, guys, that was all for my brand new DVD Blu-ray Tuesday shopping video today. Like I always say, if you guys enjoy these shopping videos, definitely give this video a thumbs up. Also in the comments below, let me know, you know, what you guys picked up on DVD, Blu-ray, or 4K if you guys picked up anything today. Also as well, let me know what you guys thought of all the DVDs, Blu-rays, and 4Ks that are reviewed at the end of this video. If you guys have seen them, what you thought, and also if you guys plan on picking any of them up. But anyway, though, guys, now stay tuned for the brand new reviews. And the first one I got here is from Lionsgate. Now, this is one I just want you guys know was available. This is the 5-movie series, all the films are based on V.C. Andrews, the Casteel family, a series of books. So it has all 5 books were turned into films here. So it has Heaven, Dark Angel, Fallen Hearts, Gates of Paradise, and Web of Dreams. V.C. Andrews is also the author of the Flowers in the Attic series, and Lifetime turned those series of books into films a number of years back. And I really liked their versions of those. I also really loved Flowers in the Attic, the 80s film, which starred Christy Swanson. That was one of those movies I always really loved. And this one, though, if you guys know V.C. Andrews, you know, books and writing and everything like that, all the series, they always deal a lot with like family drama and like things in the past that you kind of find out about, like mysteries and secrets going on and behind the scenes with family and all these sort of weird go-ons and that kind of stuff. There's a whole lot of drama, and this is basically, though, this series, it starts off, though, with this family. It doesn't have a lot of money. The one girl and the kids are getting like picked on in school because they don't have a lot of money, and you kind of know some things that happened in the past. You come to find out more and more as these go along, but the one girl, though, comes to find out, though, something about her mother. And it kind of changes everything, the way she sees herself and everything when she discovers this. She also, too, she has a bad relationship with her father because her father really has this dislike for her. And you kind of are finding out more about why this is going on and everything. But like I said, though, I want to let you guys know that this was available, like I said, the V.C. Andrews Casteel family series of films here from Lionsgate. And the next one I got here is from Lionsgate as well. And this is the 4K Ultra HD edition here of Knives Out, which includes the 4K, the Blu-ray, and the digital copy of the film. Now, this is a movie, though, I heard so many really, really good things about. Totally missed seeing this one in theaters. And like from the trailers and everything, it looked like a whodunit film, kind of like Clue and like Murder on the Orient Express. And it was that kind of film, but it had like so much more to the story and the characters and what was going on than just like a standard whodunit. There was like so much more to it. But I really like this one a lot. Essentially, though, this is about Christopher Plummer's character's family. You know, his character is celebrating his 85th birthday. So it's at his huge mansion. And, his family all come together to it for his party. And they have like sort of their own kind of drama going on about like his kids, and like his kids, they're having their own problems in their life, and the one kid wants to like played by Michael Shannon's character, wants to kind of control, because like Christopher Plummer's character is like this author who's written all these books, and you know, they kind of are setting up like motives, because basically what happens, though, is in the beginning of this movie you find out that Christopher Plummer's character had died, and it looks to be like a suicide, but it's kind of like not, it's kind of up in the air to if it really he did this, or it's like, you know, it could have been like something like set up or something like that. Because in the very beginning of this movie, you see all the family members coming back to the house, and this is the very beginning, and they're coming back because the police have called them in. The two cops and the one investigator played by Daniel Craig have called them back because, you know, as it looks like it was a suicide, and Christopher Plummer's character, you know, committed suicide. There's a lot of up in the air things about it, and Daniel Craig's character especially is kind of looking into this, and he's going and talking to the family members, talking to Ana de Armas's character, who is what plays Christopher Plummer's nurse, and talking to kind of everyone, getting their side of the story, getting like when they last saw him, and like anything weird they heard, anything weird that they saw. And it's kind of one of those things, like kind of looking into the whole thing. And it's one of those movies where once you kind of think you know one thing, then something else happens, and then you think you found out about something, but then there's more to the whole thing. And it's a really good movie for lots and lots of twists and things going on. I honestly really like this one. I know Ana de Armas, you know, got a Golden Globe nomination. I thought she did a really, really good job in the film. This movie has a great cast. Like I said, it has Daniel Craig, it has Chris Evans, it has Jamie Lee Curtis, Michael Shannon, Jamie Lee Curtis, and Tony Collette, though, play Christopher Plummer's character's kids in the film. So they have, like, their own kind of problems, and, like, Michael Shannon's character is, like, having all these problems because, like, his father, like I said, Christopher Plummer's character is this author, and he wants him to, like, sell the rights to, like, make movies out of his stuff, and it's all sorts of stuff going on. But this one, though, if you guys have not seen this one, an absolute must-watch. 4K-wise, though, looks great on 4K. And like I said with 4K, the big thing that you always notice is the HDR, which is the contrast levels. It's much, much darker levels of the contrast and, like, just the details and everything, especially the brightness levels. I always feel like, too, 4K is a much, much brighter, more vibrant picture. And this movie has really, really cool cinematography, the way it's shot and everything. On here, though, it has a whole bunch of different features. It has a commentary track on here with the director, as well as this director of photography. It has deleted scenes on there with option or commentary track with the director. It has a Making a Murder multi-part documentary on the film. It has an in-theater commentary track with the director, a director and cast Q&A, a marketing gallery. So lots and lots of stuff on this one. But this is one, like I said, would highly recommend you guys check this one out. Really, really love this one. The next one here is from Searchlight Pictures. And this is the movie that was up for Best Picture. Also, the director, Taika Waititi, got the Academy Award for Adapted Screenplay of this film. And I always really like his movies. But this movie here is JoJo Rabbit. But, you know, the director also made The Hunt for the Wild People, which I really thought that was a great movie that kind of went under the radar. And it starred the kid who went in to be in Deadpool 2. And also he did, like, What We Did in the Shadows, Thor Ragnarok. I don't know. I always love his sense of humor and everything. And this is basically, though, this is set during the time of, you know, Nazis and everything during the war. It's basically about this kid and his mother, played by Scarlett Johansson. And this kid, though, happens to have an imaginary friend. And this is the time when Hitler is alive, but this kid has an imaginary friend, and the imaginary friend is Hitler. And it's done, the movie's done as a satire, so, like, Hitler is kind of goofy and, like, kind of like almost like Drop Dead Fred-ish. Like, you know, the movie Drop Dead Fred, like, Hitler's doing, like, goofy stuff and kind of, like, because it's from the perspective of this kid, so that's kind of the way he's, like, you know, kind of thinks Hitler would be and everything. But essentially, though, in the beginning of this film, the kid goes to a Nazi training camp for kids, where it's kind of like for kids to go and train there and everything. It's kind of like a summer camp kind of program thing they go to. But the kid there, he accidentally, you know, one day he grabs this explosive, and the explosive ends up blowing up. So he ends up getting injured, so he ends up going back home. And he comes to find out, though, that his mother, played by Scarlett Johansson, has hidden this girl who's Jewish in the kind of like this hidden room up in the one bedroom upstairs. So he discovers this, and it's basically, though, about him when he finds out about this girl. It's kind of like there what goes on from there. But this movie was so well done. Like, I can totally see why this movie was up for Best Picture and, like, had all the other nominations, because it really, really was well done. Like, I honestly really love this movie. This is one I didn't get to see in theaters and really wish that I would have, because honestly, though, if you guys are up in the air with seeing this one, this is an absolute must watch. And like I said, I like the way they were able to, they brought the humor into this film with the satire aspects and everything. But then it also was very, there was a lot of sad moments as well. Like, it was one of those movies where there was, like, kind of like a couple different scenes with tears and stuff in this movie, because it really was an emotional movie and everything. But I honestly, an absolute must watch here. Has on here, though, I think it's like a 30-minute making of about the production of the film. It has on here a commentary track with the director, as well as deleted scenes and outtakes on this one as well. The next one here is from Universal, and I think this is the fifth film in the series. I'm not 100% sure what film this is in the series, but this is the Dragonheart film, the brand new Dragonheart film called Dragonheart Vengeance. This one has the Blu-ray, the DVD, and the digital copy of the film. And I'm pretty sure I only ever saw the first Dragonheart film. And I remember that when that first came out. I remember as a kid, too, I was always mixing it up with the one called Dragon World, which I think was, like, around the similar time. So as a kid, I was always mixing them up. I don't know why I was always doing that. And this is basically, though, about this one kid whose family was killed by these, this is like during the time of, like, the medieval time era. And this kid's family was killed by these terrible, like sort of Viking characters. And the kid wants to go and get revenge on them. So he kind of goes into town trying to figure out who he can find to kind of help him track down these people and go after the people that killed his family. And, like, people there are not wanting to help him and everything. But this is set in a world where there are dragons. And in this one, they're talking about at the very beginning how there's, like, these different dragons in different areas. And the kid goes to find this dragon. And the dragon's voiced by Helena Buckingham. talking Carter. And it's basically, though, the kid trying to talk to the dragon to help, have the dragon help, but the dragon is like, not, doesn't want to. And it's kind of like this other guy was like tracking him around, like when he was trying to get help, you know, in the town. So he kind of comes to help. And it's kind of like about the you know, like a revenge film, essentially, about trying to track down, you know, and get rid of the people, you know, and get revenge on the people that, you know, killed this kid's family. And this one has on here, though, a making of, a couple of different making of featurettes on this one here. Next one here is from Paramount. This is a show that airs on CBS All Access, so I don't have that, so I wasn't able to see it. So I was really glad to get to watch this one. There's also a Blu-ray of this one is available. I got a DVD, though, from Paramount to review. But this one here is the Twilight Zone series. This is season one of the series. Like I said, this airs on, I think it's like called CBS All Access is where this one is on, where they also have like Picard, you know, the new Star Trek series. This one, though, I actually really like this one. This is hosted by Jordan Peele, you know, who was, you know, and of course from Key and Peele and the director of Us and Get Out. And, you know, because there was a Twilight Zone series, of course, you know, the original series, and then there was one in the 80s. And this one, though, what was cool, though, was they did it like a takeoff on the episode with the thing, you know, the character on the wing of the plane. And it was like with, basically, the character goes onto, Adam Scott's character goes onto an airplane and finds this, like, kind of iPod kind of thing, this kind of weird-looking iPod, like, you've never seen before, like, this weird look to it, and on there, it's like a podcast, he starts listening to it, and it's, like, warning him, saying, kind of, like, saying, like, it's, like, set in the podcast that was, like, recorded later, but he's somehow hearing it, saying, oh, there's something, there was something bad happened on the plane, and this plane went missing, and he's, like, everything he's hearing is, like, what's going on right now, so he's, like, trying to stop it, so instead of there being, like, something on the wing of the plane, he has this iPad that's like telling him things, and it's like, of course, he's like cracking up on the plane, and you know, they're all coming after him. But there was I think there was 10 episodes on here. And I watched a couple ones of this one, but I actually thought this was a really cool series. And it's, you know, like I said, it's an updated version of the series. And it's, and it has a takeoff on that one, but the other ones are new episodes as well, you know, new stories. On here, though, it has a bunch of different featurettes. It has music video, a commentary track on select episodes, deleted scenes, a gag reel. So lots and lots of features on this one here. The next one here is from Paramount as well. This is one I just want you guys to know is available. And this is the 30th anniversary limited edition 4K Blu-ray digital copy steelbook here of the Sean Connery, Alec Baldwin film, The Hunt for Red October here. And this one here, like I said, just want you guys to know this one is available on steelbook. And I'll show you guys, though, a look inside at this one. Here's a look, though, at the back. Here's a look here at the front. And inside, though, it has the Blu-ray as well as the digital copy and then the 4K on this one. Like I said, just want you guys to know this one's available from Paramount. And the next one I got here is from Sony. This was a really good character piece film here. Really great, like, acting performances and dialogue and everything. And it's a movie here called Frankie, which stars Isabella Huppert. Hopefully I'm saying her name wrong. She's been in lots and lots of films throughout the years. Recently was in the film Greta, but lots and lots of stuff that she's been in. It's essentially, though, about her character and her husband, played by Brendan Gleeson, and they're vacationing in Portugal. And essentially, though, something is going on with her. And, like, for one reason or another, and I don't want to spoil what's going on, but she's, like, invited people from her past, like an ex-boyfriend, you know, family members and stuff like that, all to where they're staying and where they're living for their vacation. And basically, they all come together, and it's kind of like one of those character piece ones where it's like you find out more about these people and their lives, and then like you find out more about what's going on with her. But it's one of those movies that's really, really well shot. Like I said, it's a heavy dialogue film, so there's really, really good dialogue and character development to these characters. And it's just one of those movies where it's kind of like it lets the scenes kind of breathe with the dialogue and the discussions and everything on here. But I thought this was actually a really, really good one here. This one has on here feature-wise, it has a Q&A with the director, as well as Isabel Huppert, as well as a theatrical trailer on this one. And the next one I got here is from Screen Media, and this is a show I had heard a lot of really, really good things about. This is the complete first season here of the show, Fleabag here. And this one stars Phoebe Waller-Bridge. This is basically, though, about her character who is, you know, it's all done, the show is kind of in the style almost like of a show like with like Malcolm in the Middle, where the character, you know, breaks and like talks to the audience. So she's basically, it's her character, though, you know, living in London, and it's all about, you know, her like relationships with her sister, people that she's dating, the problems that are going on in her life. Like her friend recently died, and they, you know, both owned a cafe together, and like the she's kind of like because she the friend had died, the cafe's not doing well. She's having all kind of financial problems, and kind of like she ends up with having all kind of problems and stuff like that. So she, like I said, it breaks to the scenes of her like talking to the audience, saying, "Oh, my sister's looking at me really weird here because I, you know, I'm wearing this top of hers that, you know, went missing from her years ago, and she always wondered where it is, and now she knows that I have it." And it's like basically just like all of her kind of problems and like, you know, going on and this, you know, the issues in her life and stuff. It's kind of got like Curb Your Enthusiasm kind of aspects as well, with her character just having like lots of little problems that kind of keep happening, everything here. This is, and it also stars in here Olivia Colman, of course, you know, was in The Favorite and lots of stuff, but a really, really good show here. And the next ones here are from Gravitas Ventures, and this movie here is called After She Wakes. It's a very, very creepy film with some really creepy visuals. This is from the director of the film The Forest, which I actually really like The Forest. I thought there was some really creepy stuff to that movie as well. This one, though, is basically about this mother and her daughter, and she's taking care of her daughter because, like, her youngest newborn had died, and you find out more about how this had happened. But after this happened, though, it broke up her relationship with her husband, and everything kind of became on the rocks, and everything kind of was falling apart. But she's starting to have, though, these like crazy, really creepy dreams, and it's kind of like you don't know if like there could be some kind of a supernatural thing to what is going on here, or what exactly is causing these like horrific dreams that are happening. It's affecting her daughter as well, and it's basically, though, her trying to figure out what all this stuff means, if it's like something kind of trying to communicate or exactly what's happening. But it starts kind of coming into like into real life as well, as opposed to being in dreams. It becomes like this whole really creepy, like I said, super atmospheric film with all kind of things going on. But I actually really like this one here. Like I said, this one is called After She Wakes. The next one here is from Gravitas Ventures as well, and it's a movie here called The Mandela Effect. And this one here is basically, though, about you know, something had happened to this one's, you know, child. And it's like after this happened and the death of this, you know, couple's child, it's basically, though, the husband, though, he starts having these weird kind of things happening where, you know, like if you don't know the Mandela Effect, it's like basically about how people remember things in certain ways differently. And like, but then like groups of people remember these things, like, you know, the Monopoly guy having like, you know, the eye thing, monocle. And like, but then the Monopoly, you know, doesn't have that. And like, but everyone remembers the Monopoly guy having that. Or like, the idea of people, you know, like remembering the one character having braces in, you know, and 007, and then people thinking that, and like all these different kind of things about people kind of remembering things, and the Berenstain Bears, and all these kind of things that people, groups of people remember one way, but somehow no one, like, it's not the way it is. So that's kind of like what this is dealing with. This guy starts to, after his kid had, you know, dies, and what is going on, he starts like seeing things in different ways, and then like starting to kind of think that there's some kind of a crossover to reality, because things are really like pictures that are, you know, his wife is remembering them at different locations, and then he's starting to see really weird things. And like, it's a really, really interesting movie here. Like I said, this one here is called The Mandela Effect. This one has on here, feature wise a commentary track on here with the directors on this one. The next ones here are all from moviezing.com, and I have a link below where you guys can order these ones for the best price. This one here is also a Lionsgate title. Now, this one is also an A24 film as well, and this is a movie here called In Fabric. And this one is a movie that if you guys are a fan of, like, Dario Argento and that kind of look, this movie totally has, like, the look of, like, Suspiria, especially, like, with the way it's styled and, like, filmed and the music and everything. This is essentially, though, about this, like, cursed dress. This one woman who is, like, it deals a lot with her, too. Like, she has, like a personal ad in the paper where she's taken out, where, you know, where people can, like, you know, call this number to meet her for dates and stuff like that. And like, cause she's always trying to go on dates and everything like that through this personal ad. But she goes and buys this new dress to go at this dress store. It's like a really weird dress shop. And she goes there, and it's like this red dress. And basically, though, the second she goes to buy this dress, she buys it from the woman there who's acting really strange. And there's like, it's kind of got, like I said, it's a Suspiria aspect, too, with what's going on in this dress shop. But essentially, though, she buys this dress, and, like, there's something really weird about it. And, like, she washes it, like, puts it in the washing machine one night, and then, like, it totally, like, breaks the washing machine. The washing machine starts going, like, insane and, like, blowing up and falling apart and all sorts of weird things. And, like I said, it deals with this weird go-ons at this dress shop. And it kind of, like, that you know that there is something, like, cursed about this dress going on. It's actually a really interesting, really, really stylized film here. And the next one here is from MovieZing.com as well, and this is also from Adler and Associates Entertainment. It's a movie here called Blood River, and this one has in here Camille Keaton from I Spit in Your Grave, Linnea Quigley from, you know, Return of the Living Dead. And this is basically, though, it's kind of like a group of, like, is this kind of this weird mansion out in the middle of the woods, and it's kind of like all these sort of like bad things that have happened to people who end up, like, wandering out into the woods nearby. They get, like, attacked, and, like, bad things happen to them. It's about a group of, though, these women who are, like, they kind of, like, you don't know if they're, like, witches or vampires or exactly what they're doing, but they, like, kind of, like, anyone that kind of comes into this area, though, they, like, lure them in, and they're, like, you know, all these certain kind of things that are going on there and stuff. But it's actually a pretty cool movie, though, and there's some pretty cool characters and stuff in here, and a really cool location. Like I said, it was also cool seeing, you know, Linnea Quigley and Camille Keaton together in this movie here. Like I said, though, this one here is called Blood River. And the next one here is from MovieZing.com as well, and this is also a Paramount title. This is Grease 2 here on Blu-ray. This is one I had never seen before, and this stars Michelle Pfeiffer. And I believe this is one of her earliest films, like one of her first films. I think this might have been done, like, right before Scarface, I believe, or around the same time or so. And this one is basically, though, about new characters, though, at the same school where the original Grease was. And it's like, you know, Michelle Pfeiffer's character is a member of, like, the Pink Ladies, who's, like, the most popular girls at school. And this one guy, played by Max Caulfield, comes from England to go to school there. But he's, like, not, like, part of the cool guy group and everything, but he starts to like her. And it's kind of like, you know, she doesn't want to date him because, you know, he's not part of this group. So it's kind of like this whole big thing with that. And, of course, it's, you know, a musical, so it kind of breaks into songs and stuff. And a lot of characters, too, a handful of them from the first film, you know, are back, like Eddie Deason's character, a couple other ones as well. One of them, like, came back to school to, like, get their, like, degree for, like, because she's, like, doing, like, a beauty school, and she needs to learn, like, compositions for making makeup or something like that was going on. I don't know. There's, like, the songs in here, though, are not as strong as in the first movie, but there still was a really, really fun movie here. Next one's here. The next two are both from MovieZing as well. This one is also a freestyle releasing title. There's nothing really bad on the cover on these covers, but I'm just covering up just so no one says anything. But this one here is a documentary called Porndemic. And this is basically, though, this is actually a really well done documentary, you know, here. And this is, like I said, there's nothing bad on the cover, just so no one says anything. But it's basically, though, a documentary that aired, I believe, originally on Showtime. And it's all about the AIDS epidemic in the adult film industry, that where it really came into play in 1998. When girls were getting tested positive for AIDS, and it became a huge thing about how has this happened, and it was about, like, the one woman who was doing research to try and track down who was patient zero of this, and of course, it's talking to the adult film actor who was patient zero, and there's a whole lot of controversy around if this guy knew, and if he was forging documents and forging his tests, you know, and pretending like they were real, and it goes, and it's a really, really well done. It has, like, Ron Jeremy in here, Ginger Lynn, a lot of other adult film actors and people in the business, and people who were, like, were in Hustler, and all these different things, all kind of talking about this time where it almost really ended the adult film industry at this point. And it was a really, really well done documentary. The next one here is from MovieZing.com as well, and this is also from MRG, the Meridian Releasing Group. This one, though, this cover's a little gross, that's why I covered it over. But this is a movie here called Submission. And this is basically, though, about this guy who ends up meeting, you know, this girl Because he's like kind of like, she's like a escort that he meets, and he's kind of like saying, well, if we meet up, we're going to do this, and I don't want to do this, and I have all these certain things. So they go to this hotel room to meet up, and the one girl's like, oh, I have to get ready, I'm going to go in the bathroom. And he's like waiting a while, and she doesn't come out, and he goes in there, and she finds that she's killed herself. And it's kind of him panicking, like, what am I going to do? How am I going to do this? But the what's cool about this movie is the way it's shot. It's all shot in these interesting perspectives, like it's like a drone footage, you know, going to like a restaurant scene in the very beginning. Then it like cuts the guy, like zooming in on the guy's head. Then it comes to like the perspective of his view, like what he sees. So it's done like first person perspective of his. Then at times it like leaves his perspectives and then kind of shows the general room perspective. Then it goes to perspectives of other people a little bit. And it's just like a really interesting way the movie is shot. That's like one of the most interesting aspects of this movie, is just the technical things to the film. And the whole outcome is interesting in this one as well. But it's basically, though, the guy's calling his sister, who's like, works as the police force, and he's like telling her what he's going to do. And it becomes this huge to-do thing here. Like I said, this one here is called Submission. The next ones here are from Vinegar Syndrome. And this one is Extro 3, the third film in the Extro series. I've never seen Part 2. I don't think Part 2 has ever been released on DVD, at least on Blu-ray in the U.S. I have seen Part 1. That one came out as like a region-free release from, I think it was Second Sight. I ended up buying that one like a couple months back or a year or so back. That's a really fun movie. The third movie is a little different, though, with like the concept of what's going on with the alien. It's basically, though, about like these soldiers that are getting sent to this one area to go there because they believe that there could be like live explosives still there, and they have to go there to kind of like check them, disarm them before they can like build in this area that they want to go to. But of course, though, the soldiers go there, and then it ends up like they end up like digging in one thing and kind of letting out this alien. So the movie kind of has the vibe of them like in this small kind of islandy kind of area, of like Predator. It sort of has that kind of feel to it a little bit, and they're basically there with this alien coming after them, and it's them trying to survive and everything. This one has on here, it's newly scanned and restored in 2K from its original 35mm camera negative. Picture quality, though, looks great on this one. Also has an interview on here with the director, has an interview on here with actor Daryl Henney, a theatrical trailer on this one as well. The next one here is from Vinegar Syndrome as well. It's a movie here called Hollywood Horror House, and this one has on here, it's newly restored in 4K from its original 35mm camera negative. This has a historical commentary track on here with David Dakota, as well as David Duvall, has on here a promotional image gallery. And this one, there was another movie, I can't remember what it was called. It kind of had a slightly similar concept to this one. This is basically about this woman who is an actress, and she's older now, and she kind of needs someone to kind of take care of her. And this guy who kind of comes in there to be like his, her nurse. And it's basically, though, he kind of like the older woman, though, who's there to take care of, like kind of likes this guy. And it's basically, though, essentially like certain weird things start to go on, and you kind of see people getting killed. It's kind of like, one of those things. It's like, is it this guy, the guy that's come there? Because you don't really know too much about this guy, and the guy seems a little strange, the way he's acting and everything. So it's one of those kind of movies. It's actually really, really interesting film here. Like I said, this one here is called Hollywood Horror House. Now the next one here is from, these ones are all Australian releases, and all of them are region free, so you guys can watch these ones in any US DVD or Blu-ray player, no problem. I'll let you know the one title that isn't, though. But this one here is from Via Vision, and this one is one I was so glad it's finally available on DVD. This one has never had a DVD or a Blu-ray release before. As far as I know, it's never had anything. And there's only ever been like a VHS of this one. And of course, at like conventions, I've always seen like bootlegs and stuff like that of this one. But I had never seen this one before. It was always really one I always wanted to see. And this is a Michael Mann film here called The Keep. Michael Mann also directed, of course, Heat. He directed Manhunter, which I really, really liked, a movie called Thief. And the one thing that's cool about this movie as well is Tangerine Dream made the music as well. It's amazing, amazing synth music in this movie. This whole movie is so trippy and so, like, out there. And then there's some really kind of scary kind of parts to this movie, too. And this movie, too, is, like, notorious because, like, Michael Mann doesn't like talking about this movie anymore because, like, the original edit of the movie was like 3 hours long, over 3 hours, and then the studio and stuff like cut it down back in the day to like, only a little over an hour and a half. So the movie does have like this vibe, like where you can tell things were cut and taken out, and, kind of speeds a certain periods of time kind of quicker than you think it would. But this is essentially, though, about this bunker. It's kind of like a bunker, kind of like underground, kind of weird thing, like almost like a mummy's tomb or something like that. And it's basically these Nazi soldiers go to this thing to kind of go there and kind of like take that as their base. But in the place, there's all these like silver crosses all over the walls of this bunker everywhere, this like big keep building. And of course, the soldiers, though, want to steal it. One of them, they start pulling off the one cross and ends up unleashing this thing in this wall. And it's like in this huge thing behind the wall, and this kind of weird kind of like cloud of like dust stuff that kills them. And then like more people are getting killed. And then a group of the Nazis there, other Nazis are coming there, head up by Gabriel Byrne's character. Brian's character, and he's kind of there trying to figure out exactly what's going on. And it's like it's hard to explain, because then it's like one character who's kind of trying to get to the keep because he's going to be there to try and like stop what's going on there. But it has these amazing like effects and stuff in this movie, these old school effects, really, really cool music. And it has I think I heard too, it was like Ian McKellen's first like American film. I was reading about it online. Ian McKellen, though, is basically this, his character is sent there to try and figure out what's going on in the keep, because his character is a Nazi and he needs to, his character is Jewish, and him and his daughter are both going there to try and like decipher what's written on the walls in there. Like I said, it's a really hard movie to explain. It's one of those movies you just have got to watch. Highly recommend you guys check this one out here, though. Really, really like this one a lot. If you guys have seen this movie, though, let me know what you guys thought. But picture quality on here too, you know, it is, of course, it's a DVD, but picture quality on here, I thought this looks really, really good here. Like I said, I had never seen it before, but I've seen like videos online of like the clips of like the VHS, and this looks way better than that. And it's also in widescreen as well. And the next one I got here is from ViaVision as well. This one, of course, is region free as well. This is the Anaconda, the complete anthology here on DVD. This has all five films in the Anaconda, series of films. It has, of course, Anaconda Offspring, Anaconda's Trail of Blood, and then Lake Placid versus Anaconda. So they took the Lake Placid, you know, giant crocodile alligator, and then put that, you know, tied that together with the Anaconda. So it was kind of cool how they put them together. But like, these are series of movies that I always really liked. Of course, they were dealing with this huge snake, and the first movie was Jennifer Lopez, and she's going this like kind of to do this documentary film out in the middle of the Amazon, and she comes across John Voight's character whose boat's broken down, and it also has like Eric Stoltz in there and Ice Cube, Owen Wilson. They're all like part of the documentary that they're working on, the crew for the documentary, and they end up picking up John Voight, who's like stranded out there, and he kind of tells them the wrong way to go, and they end up coming across this enormous snake which she's trying to, you know, catch. And it just becomes this whole big to do of this crazy killer snake. It's actually such a fun movie. These are actually really, really fun movies here. This has on here, though, the Anaconda making a featurette, deleted scenes, and each film as well is on its own disc. So it's Anaconda, Anaconda's The Hunt for the Blood Orchard, Anaconda Offspring, Anaconda's Trail of Blood, and Lake Placid versus Anaconda. And the next one here is from ViaVision as well. Like I said, all these ones are region free. There's only one coming up. I'll let you guys know which one that is. This one here is a Timeless Season 2. This is a fun, series, and I think this only ran for two seasons. I might have been three. I'm not 100% certain. And this is basically, though, about this team of like scientists who created this kind of time travel type device where they can kind of travel back into certain events of time, and like they can kind of change things and kind of stop certain things from happening. But it's one of those kind of things there where like, you know, it kind of gets stolen and certain things happen. So they have all sorts of kind of problems. And it's also that kind of thing where you can't really change stuff. And if you try and help certain people, then things can really have drastic effects in the future. It's one of those kind of like situations where it can be a serious problem. This one has on here, though, season 2 finale, The Miracle of Christmas feature-wise. It also has on here deleted scenes and a gag reel on this one here. And this one here is a three-disc set. The next ones here are Australian releases as well, and these ones are all from Umbrella Entertainment. This one is region-free as well. And this is a movie which I had never seen before. It stars Molly Ringwald, called Cut. I really like this movie. I always love movies, too, that are about making movies. Like, anything about making movies and that kind of stuff, I always really like. And this movie, though, starts off with Molly Ringwald's character making this, like, horror movie. It starts off 13 years before, and it takes place 13 years, like, after this movie. But basically, though, just making this indie horror film. And the guy who plays the killer kind of cracks up and starts killing people on the set. And then he ends up like getting killed. And it's 13 years later. The movie was never finished. And this film school program, like a film class, is like working on their like final exam film that they're going to do. And they find out about this movie, how it was never finished because the teacher was one of the producers on the movie. And they find out about how the print still exists, but it was never finished. And they're like, oh, well, what if for our final project, we decide that, what if we actually finish this movie and finally complete it? So they end up deciding to do this. And the thing is, though, this film is like cursed because other people tried to make the movie again in the past, and they had like a terrible things happen to them and die and all sorts of things. But you know it's a bad thing. But the teacher's like, oh, well, I guess so. And they end up calling Molly Ringwald's character and getting her to come back and play like the mother in the movie. It's really interesting because they had like a little bit left they had to finish. But of course, though, they go to make this movie, and then one by one, someone is killing them off on the set. Like I said, I thought this is a really, really fun slasher film. I think this is from 2000, so it has that, like, late 90s kind of feel to it. Kind of like an Urban Legends kind of vibe. Has on here, though, a Comte track on here with the director. It has behind the scenes of Cut. It has Hayride to Hell starring Kyle Mooney, like a short film on this one. Cast and crew interviews, a theatrical trailer. So lots of features in this one. If you guys have seen this one, let me know what you guys thought. The next one here is from Umbrella Entertainment, and this is region free as well. And this is the Running Man, the Arnold Schwarzenegger film. This is a movie I always really liked. This one, I always think of this because it was around the same time as Total Recall, so I always kind of think they had like a similar sort of kind of futuristic kind of vibe to this. This is Arnold Schwarzenegger's character is like framed for something that he didn't do and gets like put into like this prison sort of sentence thing. And they have a thing going on where you can compete in these kind of crazy kind of games where it's like a televised game hosted by Richard Dawson's character. You know, of course, was the host of The Family Feud, and he's it's basically televised and watched around the world, and people all watch this thing, and you have to kind of fight the people and like survive the whole thing and can be the one winner and all this kind of stuff. It's a really, really cool movie. Like I said, futuristic film, Arnold Schwarzenegger. I've always really liked this one here. Like I said, this one here is The Running Man. This is another one that I always loved, especially as a kid. I remember even as a kid, though, I always noticed this movie was kind of like a Jurassic Park movie, but not exactly. Instead of being like about dinosaurs, it was about like undiscovered gorillas and that kind of stuff. And it's a movie here called Congo. And this is one of those movies, especially as a kid, I watched this movie so many times. And every time I think of this movie, too, I always think of this, because I remember when the DVD of this came out years ago. I remember buying the DVD of this one when it was brand new at a place called Blowout Video. I don't know if you guys ever remember that one. It was sort of like a chain where they had one in Florida that was like in like an outlet in Orlando, Florida. And they also had one in New York Times Square. And I think there might have been a couple other ones, but it was called Blowout Video. There was one that me and Danny, the Center Starker, went to called Blowout DVD. It was not that. This is a place called Blowout Video. But I remember buying this movie there. I don't know. I always remember that. And if any of you guys remember that place, it was like this amazing video place that I always, you know, wish that I did like the videos I do now, going to stores, and I wish I documented this place. And I bet there's like no documentation, probably not even any pictures of this place that exist. But this movie, though, always reminded me, though, of a little bit of like Jurassic Park a little bit, because it's like this adventure kind of thing. I don't know, it just had this sort of similar vibe. But it's basically, though, about a group of these people going to this island to try and like track something down out in the middle of the African jungle. That's essentially what it is. And like they go out and Tim Curry's in the movie, and he's there for like certain reasons because he's trying to get like something that's in these mines. And then Dylan Walsh's character has his monkey that he's bringing with him, his gorilla that can talk through sign language. It's a really interesting movie. But like looking at it now, though, it's like the gorillas and stuff like that have this real like suit like look, because it's all suits and stuff. It's, you know, it's kind of like peculiar, some of it, like the way they look. But I really like this movie. It's one of those movies, as a kid, I've always loved this movie. So it's just a really fun movie to watch this one again here. This one's region-free as well. And when I say region-free, that means basically what I mean by that is you guys can watch this one in U.S. Blu-ray players. You don't have to have any all-region, multi-region. They play perfectly fine in U.S. players. And the next one here, this one's region-free as well. This is a movie that stars Will Forte called Extraordinary. And this is one I heard a lot of things about this movie. This is a really fun film. It's basically about this woman who has, like, she's like a driving instructor, and she has these psychic abilities where she can kind of talk to spirits and kind of sense things and stuff like that, but she's kind of doesn't use her gifts, and it's like people always trying to, like, get her to do it, and she doesn't want to. And it's basically, though, about this one guy who's, like, having these weird certain things going on in his house, and, like, you know, he convinces her to kind of help because, like, she kind of likes this guy. So it's kind of like her looking into this stuff at the same time. Will Forte's character is this, like, rock musician who hasn't had, like, a hit in a really long time, and he's kind of falling, like, into obscurity a little bit, and he's trying to, like, kind of summon up, a demon or something to try to, like, make it so he has, like, all the power and everything, and he's doing all these weird incantations and making people float and all sorts of weird stuff going on, and it's like, it's actually a really, really fun movie. It's kind of like that one movie a little bit, like, called House Guest a little bit. I think that was what it was called, or House Homebound a little bit, or Homebody, something like that. It's kind of like that movie a little bit. And the next one I got here is from Umbrella Entertainment as well. It's a movie here called The Parts You Lose. This one stars Aaron Paul, Mary Elizabeth Winstead. This is basically, though, about Aaron Paul's character who, you know, stole this money. And it's basically like the people that he was with, they've been found and arrested, and he's, like, out, and, like, he, you know, he's getting away, and he kind of got injured. He's out kind of in the middle of nowhere, you know, in this, and it's real snowy and everything. And this kid who's Mary Elizabeth Winstead's character's son finds this guy, Aaron Paul's character, and decides to bring him back to the barn to help him. And it's basically, though, he's, like, you know, keeping him hidden. And, like, they become kind of, like, they're talking and all this kind of stuff. And people are, of course, are trying, like, the cops and everything are trying to find where he is. So it becomes this whole big thing about this kid keeping this secret and all this kind of stuff. It's a really, really interesting character piece here. And the last one from Umbrella Entertainment. Now, this one is the one that is region locked. This one is, so you'd have to put this one into a region-free DVD player to play this one. So keep that in mind. This is the only one out of all the Australian releases that I showed you guys that is region-locked. And this is a movie here called Good Posture. This is basically, though, about this girl whose father is in Paris with his new younger girlfriend. And, you know, because, like, he can't take care of the girl, watch his daughter, she ends up going to stay with this family friend. And the one friend, she's a writer. And at the beginning of this movie, too, this girl recently broke up with her boyfriend, so she's kind of in a weird state over what has happened and going on in her life and everything. But when she gets there, though, it's kind of all about what she's going through, and then, like, she finds out the one woman, like I said, was a writer who kind of has become reclusive and hasn't really been seen or written in a long time, and kind of, like, is kind of, like, weird the way she acts, and she has all these certain things that she doesn't like, and certain, like, don't do this, and all these kind of different rules the way she acts and everything. And essentially, though, this girl wants to try and impress her ex-boyfriend and kind of, like, say, oh, I'm doing something here, I have these big plans, and I'm making this documentary, and she wants to say that she's making a documentary on this woman who's the author, who's kind of not been in the limelight or been seen in a really long time. It's kind of a character piece about all that's going on here, but it's a really well done film here. The next one here is from Breaking Glass Pictures. It's a movie here called Feedback, and this is a really interesting movie. This is about this kind of, like, radio show that kind of has a lot of controversy behind it, and the radio show host, and, like, he's been, like, in the beginning of the movie, he was talking about how he was kidnapped recently, and people have all these threats against him and just don't like him and like the things that he's saying, and it's all sort of problems that he's had. And one of the persons that he was, you know, had done radio shows with in the past, like his partner, he's come back and he's going to be on a guest on his show tonight, because it takes place all during the one night. And when he goes there to do the show, though, he's been on there for a little while, and then all of a sudden he sees in the you know, where they're doing the switching and the audio and all that kind of stuff, these guys wearing these masks, beating up the one guy and basically taking the show hostage. And it's kind of like, almost like an insane version of Airheads a little bit, what's going on in the radio station, but then it has all this stuff going on. You find out about it happening, what the reason is, but basically these guys are trying to hold the radio show host hostage and saying, you have to read from this script, you can't say that we're here, you can't make a big notice about this, you have to, we want, they basically, they have all these things that they want him to do. And he has to, if he doesn't do what he says, they say where they're going to kill those people in the mixing room and all that kind of stuff. But it's a really, really interesting, well-acted film here. Also, really like the music in this movie as well. The last one here is from Wild Eye Releasing. And this is the new film from Mark Pallone. And this is Amityville Island. And this is basically, though, about, it starts off with this woman who has moved to Amityville. And it's kind of like, she's like, oh, I'm moving here with my kids. And like, I think it's going to be a fresh new start. And they move to this house. And right before she gets to the new house, though, she sees, like, on the side of the road, this woman selling all these clothes and stuff like that. And she's like, oh, I could use a deal. I'll buy this stuff. And, like, the woman looks really strange. She's like, oh, no one wants these things. They're from this cursed house. And then, like, you know, she sells them to the woman, and then she takes them back to her house. And, of course, though, since they're cursed, it kind of makes her go crazy. And she, like, kills the kids. And then she ends up in the sane asylum kind of prison-type situation. But this all kind of deals with all the bases of the Amityville house and like people getting possessed and kind of made to do things. But at the prison kind of insane asylum that she's at, they're doing some weird type of experiments and that kind of stuff going on, you know, there. They all deal with like the Amityville curse and kind of controlling people and stuff like that on this one. On here, though, feature wise, this has a commentary track and trailers for other Wild Eye Releasing titles. Anyway, though, guys, that's all for the review portion of this video. Thanks again for watching, subscribing, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.